Hello everyone. In this video lecture, I am going to discuss about the IR sensor interfacing with the Arduino boards. Okay, in the previous lectures, I have discussed about the Arduino IDE, which is used for writing the Arduino codes, Proteus, that is basically used for circuit simulation. Okay, those will be useful in this video lecture. Okay, so let us start with the topics that I am going to cover in this video lecture. First one is the hardware software requirement. What is IR sensor? IR sensor connection with the Arduino. Arduino code and Proteus simulation, and the final one is the hardware implementation. So these are the topics that I am going to cover in this video lecture. Okay, now first one is the hardware software requirement. Okay, which are the software and hardware you require? Okay, or basically which are the hardware you require if you want to make a project for object detection. Basically IR sensor is used for object detection. Okay, so which are the hardware component you required? Okay, so first one is any Arduino board. I am going to use Arduino Uno board. You can also use the Arduino Nano board also. Okay, then IR sensor. Okay, LEDs basically used to indicate that something has been detected. Okay, next one is a jumper wire for connection of IR sensor and LEDs with the Arduino boards. Then USB cable, which is basically used for loading the program on Arduino Uno board from computer or laptop. So this is a medium USB cable. Or it is also used for giving the power supply. Okay, then breadboard, we will be installing the IR sensor, okay, and breadboard, IR sensor and LEDs on the breadboards. Okay, and final one, if you want to simulate this circuit, then what you require? You require a Proteus software, and for writing the codes, you require the Arduino IDE board. Okay. So the next one is what is IR sensor basically, how it looks like. So this is the IR sensor module, okay, which is available in the market. Okay, you can see it is a 3-pin. One is output pin, one is VCC, another one is a ground pin. Okay, basically what is IR sensor? It is an electronic device which emits the light. Okay, and why it emits the light? To sense something, to sense the object from the surroundings. Okay, IR sensor can measure the heat of object as well as detect the motion. So basically two purpose, for measuring the heat and for detection of the object. Now usually in the infrared spectrum, basically IR sensor consists of one IR LED that emits the infrared waves. Okay, all the object in the infrared spectrum, all the objects radiate some form of thermal energy. Okay, this type of radiations are invisible to our eyes. We cannot see. Okay, you can see here white color is nothing but the IR transmitter and black color is nothing but the IR receiver. Okay, so it looks like an LED one. Okay, but it is not LED. We can not see those infrared waves. Okay, but infrared sensor can detect this radiation. So basically infrared sensor detect the temperature or heat of the object. Okay, the IR emitter, what is IR sensor consists of two things, emitter and that is a receiver. So emitter is basically simple IR LED. Okay, that is a light emitting diode. Okay, and detector is simply IR photodiode. Okay, photodiode, what is the function of photodiode? Okay, photodiode is sensitive to the IR light. When some light falls on the photodiode, then voltage changes. Okay, so photodiode is sensitive to the IR light of some wavelength which is emitted by IR LED. IR LED transmits certain infrared waves. Those are reflected by the object and received by the IR photodiode. Okay, and because of this radiation of a wave on the photodiode, its resistance changes, and resistance changes, so its output voltage changes. That is the principle of any photodiode. Okay, so when the IR light falls on the photodiode, resistance and output voltage will change in proportion to the intensity or magnitude of the IR light received. Okay, now this is a working principle. It consists of this IR transmitter and this IR receiver. This is nothing but the IR LED, white color, and black color is a photodiode. First one is IR transmitter. Infrared transmitter is a light emitting diode which emits the infrared radiation. Okay, and but though it looks like IR LED, okay, but it is, we cannot see the radiation emitted by this IR LED. It is not visible to the human eye. The next one is a IR receiver or photodiode. Okay, basically it is a IR sensor. Okay, infrared receiver or sensor which detects the radiation from the IR transmitter. IR receiver comes in the form of photodiode or phototransistor. So this may be a photodiode or phototransistor which which resistance changes based on the magnitude of the magnitude or intensity of the light falling on this. Okay, and these are infrared photodiodes are different from the normal diodes. Okay, as they detect only infrared radiations. Okay, now this is the working principle. Okay, this diagram shows the working principle of IR sensor. Here you can see this IR sensor, which consists of IR LED and photodiode. Okay, IR LED will generate the IR radiation. Those will be reflected by this object, and it will be falling on the photodiode. Okay, so now what happens? Emitter is IR LED and detector is IR photodiode. IR photodiode is sensitive to the IR light emitted by IR LED. Okay, as I told you, the photodiode's resistance and output voltage will change according to the or in proportion to the IR light falling or that or IR light received. And this is the working principle of any IR sensor. Okay, when IR transmitter emits the radiation, you can see it reaches the object and it is reflected by that object and it is received by the photodiode. Based on the intensity of the IR light received, okay, output of this sensor will change, which is connected, that output pin which is connected to the Arduino board. Okay, so now let us see the IR sensor pin configuration. So this is the module which is available in the market, which consists of three pins, VCC and ground. VCC is for supply, because it consists of some inbuilt components, and ground is for making the circuit complete. And third pin is the output pin, okay, which is connected to the Arduino IDE board. Okay, so basically plus 5 volt VCC is given, the second pin is a ground pin, and third pin is a digital out pin. Okay, which shows that if some object is detected, that output line will be, there will be high pulse on that output line. If object is not detected, there will be low pulse. So these are the three pins of any IR sensor module. Now IR sensor connection with the Arduino. So this is a graphical image of any Arduino board, okay, which consists of different IBIO ports. You can see number of IBIO lines. Okay, ground and 5 volt pin, it is also visible to you. Now this is the actual image of IR sensor, how it looks like. Okay, so here you can see it is there is output pin, ground pin and VCC. So ground and VCC are connected with the ground pin and 5 volt pin of the Arduino, and that output pin is connected with the 2 number pin of Arduino board. Okay, and 13 number pin, I have connected one LED, okay, anode of the LED, okay, and cathode is grounded. So this is a connection of IR sensor with the Arduino board. Now let us see the Proteus simulation of IR sensor connection with the Arduino board. Okay, so this is a Proteus simulation. Here IR sensor library should be there in your Proteus. If it is not there, you have to place that. Okay, in the library folder of the lab center folder. Okay, in the C drive, program files. Okay, now this is a IR sensor module. Okay, here output pin is connected to with terminal, and terminal number is pin 2. So here at pin 2, I have given the same terminal name, that is pin 2. So both are internally connected. Why this kind of arrangement is there? If I can directly connect the wire, but it ultimately increase the complexity. So simulation software will take more time. Okay. Then next one, VCC, ground number, ground pin is connected with the ground, and VCC is connected with 5 volt VCC. Okay. Now in simulation, we cannot provide the object. Okay, physical object is not present. So here one test pin is there, and with that test pin, toggle, digital toggle will be there. Okay, so if toggle is 0, nothing will be detected. If I will click on this, it will become 1. So something will be detected and LED will be on, and that LED is connected with the 13 number pin. Okay, so now let us see the simulation. So here you can see the design template of Proteus for IR sensor. Okay, as I told you, it consists of IR sensor module, there is a library you need to have, and digital toggle is there. Okay, where you can find the digital toggle? So you have to click over here, and in the keywords you have to write toggle. Okay, so you can see here toggle is available. Just click on OK and you can put it over here. Okay, now this is connected to the test pin. Okay, and I have already told how you can find out Arduino. So in keywords you have to write Arduino board, Arduino Uno. So you will find. You can write LED, so number of LEDs will be available. This is a blue color LED I have selected. Okay, now what I require, I have to double click on this, and I have to include the attach the program file path over here. Okay, so first let us understand the program. Okay, so here first initialization part is there. So 13 number pin, I have given the LED pin, and 2 number pin, this is for IR sensor. Okay, so these are the variable name assigned to 13 and 2 number pin. Okay, has obstacle is another variable which is value is initially low. Now in setup, void setup, there are two functions, void setup and void loop. So in setup, we will define first pin mode. So LED pin, that is a 13 number pin, will be output pin, and pin mode IR sensor, that is a 2 number pin, which is input pin. Okay, serial dot begin. Basically, serial dot begin is basically used when we want to display something on the serial monitor. Here it is available. Okay, that value will be displayed on the serial monitor. Okay, now next one is a void loop. Okay, where we will write our actual code. So has obstacle, that is initially zero, low value. Okay, in that variable, what will be stored? So digital write in bracket IR sensor. So IR sensor is connected basically to number pin. So it will, this function will show, check the status of two number pin. If it is low or if it is high. Okay, if it is high, then condition is there. If and else, basically conditional loop. Okay, if it is high, then what will do? Digital write in bracket LED pin high. So LED pin is a 13 number pin. So 13 number pin will become high and LED will turn on. And in serial monitor, if you want to display that something, that serial dot print top something is ahead. Okay. See this, I have this serial monitor I have used in actual hardware implementation. In this virtual simulation, in this simulation, we are not going to use that. Okay. Then else. Okay. If this condition is not satisfied, if something is not detected, so this has obstacle will be having low value. So directly program will go into the else loop. Okay. So serial dot print path is clear. Okay. That will be displayed in serial monitor. And digital write in bracket LED pin comma low. So LED pin will become low. So LED will turn on. Okay. And then that loop is, else loop is completed. And I have provided the delay in bracket 200. That is a 200 millisecond is delay is provided. And this part, this program will continuously check the status of pin number 2. If it is high or if it is low, based on that, this program will continuously run. Now, what we have to do, we have to compile this program. You have to click over here, and in the console window, you will find one hex file. Okay, you can see one hex file over here. You have to copy that hex file. Okay, now move towards the simulation part. That is a Proteus design template. Here, double click on this board and paste that path over here. Okay, now click on OK. Now here, that program hex file is loaded in this Arduino board. Okay, now what you have to do, you have to start the simulation. Okay, so if you start the simulation, okay, you can see different dots here, red dots and a blue dot. That means so that path is connected. Now here, output pin is connected with terminal. This is nothing but a terminal, and that is given name pin 2. And at here pin 2, I have also connected one terminal, and that is also given the same name pin 2. So what it will do, that will connect, both these pins are connected. Why I have not connected by means of wire? So if complex circuit is there, number of wires will increase, and ultimately complexity of that circuit will increase. So simulation software will take more processing time. Okay, now here digital toggle switch is there. So we will provide some virtual object, which is basically using, we are going to use it as a virtual object. So here zero is there, means no object is detected. So LED is not turned on. Now if I will click on here, so you can say now LED, blue color LED is turned on. That means some object is detected. So LED is turned on. Okay. Again, if I will make toggle pin to zero, here you can see I have made toggle pin zero. So LED is turned off. Okay. So this is the simulation of IR sensor interfacing with the Arduino board using Proteus. Okay. Now let us see the application of IR sensor, where it is basically used. So it is basically used in night vision devices, cameras, that is radiation thermometer. It can detect any type of obstacle and objects. So for detection, number of, if you want to detect how many objects are there. Okay. So for that it can be used. Okay. Item counter, basically which I am talking about. Then Bulgar alarm, then human body detection. So these are the application of IR sensor. Now let us move towards the actual hardware implementation. Okay, so this is the video of actual hardware implementation which I have done. Okay, so let us start with the first different components. Okay, so this is the first one is the Arduino Uno board, you can see here. Okay, which is having number of input output pins. Okay, and USB jack is also there, power jack is there. This is a USB cable, next one. Okay, basically it is used for connection of this board with the laptop. Then IR sensor module, which consists of three pins. Okay, these are one, it consists of IR transmitter and receiver. Then different jumper wires are required, male to male, male to female. Okay, then LED, which is used to indicate that something is detected. Okay, and the final one is a breadboard. Okay, so these are the components which is required. Now now you can see here different components are already connected with the Arduino boards and program is already loaded, okay, via this USB cable from the computer. Hex file is already loaded. Okay, LED is there and all these are connected by means of breadboard. Okay, now here I have opened the terminal box. See, this is the terminal box. You can see here path is clear, is printed. Okay, using that function which I already told. Okay, now nothing is there, so path is clear will be displayed over here. Okay, now if some object movement is there, now you can see this book in front of this IR sensor. So you can see LED is now turned on. Okay, so object is detected, LED is turned on, and at the same time if object is detected, okay, the what will be printed on the terminal box. So you can see stop, something is ahead, that means object is detected. Okay, so this is how IR sensor can be interfaced with the Arduino Uno board. Okay, so this is all about for this video lecture. Hope you enjoy the video. See you soon in the next video. Thank you for watching.